Good morning, students. I am Pavan, your science master. Students, I welcome you all for this virtual video class. In the previous class, I have invited student Shashivardhan, right? In this video, along with Shashivardhan, two more students are going to join. Let's all welcome them by giving a big round of applause. Let's all welcome. So, come, students. Come stand here. Come. Say hi to your friends.
Hi, friends.
He is Shashivardhan. He is Gnanacharan. She is Siri Chandana. These are the new students joining today in this virtual video class. Okay, he is familiar to you. In the previous class, we both interacted to each other. Okay, and today in this video class, these extra students are joined. Okay, students, and let's all interact to each other. And you too, watch this video till the end. And if you want to interact with me, students, you please give a comment in the comment section. I will definitely give you the idea and I will definitely give you the way to how to interact to me. Okay, students, thank you. Let's all sit and interact to each other and let's listen to the class. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Hi, students.
Hi, sir.
You please say hi to your friends.
Hi, friends.
Okay, students, in the previous class, Shashi and I interacted. You were not there in that video class, right?
Yes.
The points that what we have talked in the previous class, I would like to share with you. Students, in the previous class, we have talked about heat and measurement chapter. In the chapter, we have talked about what is temperature and what is heat and what is conversion of heat. Okay, what are the forms of energies? Heat is a form of energy, and thermometer as well. We have talked about thermometer and different types of thermometers also. Students, in this video, what I would like to teach you is expansion. What is expansion and how liquids expand on heating? You know, basically in this chapter, we are talking about liquids expand on heating. And here, what we have to take as a liquid, we have to take water as a liquid here. And how water expands on heating, there is an experiment to understand this property. What property? Expansion property. What property?
Expansion property.
Of liquids. Expansion property of liquids. To understand the expansion property of liquids, what liquid we are going to take here? Water. What liquid are we going to take here?
Water.
Every thermometer works based on only expansion property of the matter. What? Expansion property of the matter. Matter. So here in the place of matter, we are taking water. Okay? And how water expands on heating, I will show the image to you, and based on that image I will explain how water expands on heating. Okay, you can see on the screen, students, you can see on the screen, you can see here what you have to take here. Take a round bottom flask. See that? This is round bottom flask. Are you able to see this?
Yes.
What is this?
Round
bottom flask, and you have to fill it with colored water. What color water is filled here?
Red color.
Very good. Red color water is filled here. You can see there. And then you have to take a one hole rubber stopper. One hole rubber stopper. That's nothing but cork. You can see here. This is cork. And you have to close the mouth of round bottom flask with this cork, like this as shown in the figure you can see here. And you have to insert a capillary tube. What is this?
Capillary tube.
You have to insert a capillary tube. Capillary tube, down end of the capillary tube is inside the water. You make sure you have to dip the down bottom, you know, down end of the capillary tube into the water. And then what you have to take? You have to take this setup. What setup? The round bottom flask, capillary tube, and the closed mouth of the round bottom flask with the cork like this. And then you have to place this all setup where?
In
a metal trough. What is this?
Metal trough.
This is a metal trough. And you have to place like that, and then after some time, what you have to do is you have to record the level of water in the capillary tube. First of all, after marking the level of water in this capillary tube, then you have to take what? Hot water in the trough. Okay, pour boiling hot water into the trough and carefully observe the level of colored water in the capillary tube. Got it? And will you observe any change in the level of the water in the capillary tube? And how it will change? Will it change downward? Will it come downward or will it come upward?
Upward.
Yes, you can see here the level of water after you take the hot water, boiling water in the trough, you will see the level of water in the capillary tube is raised. Okay, the level of water in the capillary tube is
raised.
You took normal water in round bottom flask first of all.
Yes.
And then you took hot boiling water in metal trough and you kept the round bottom flask in the hot water. Due to the hotness of the water that you took in the metal trough, the normal water which is there in the round bottom flask is also getting warm. Okay, and due to this warmness, what happens? The level of the water in the capillary tube is raising upward, and if you take it out, the level of the water in the capillary tube is coming down. Okay, like this. You can understand the liquids expand on heating. Okay, this is the experiment how you can understand that expansion of water due to heat. Okay, that is the thing. So here you just imagine in the place of water, what you have to take in a thermometer?
Mercury or alcohol.
Mercury or?
Alcohol.
What we should take?
Mercury or alcohol.
Mercury or alcohol. Right, but here there is some difference in mercury and alcohol properties. Okay, in some thermometers mercury only taken and in some thermometers alcohol only taken. Right, but here let us see the properties of both the liquids. Okay, how do they expand and what are the properties with the temperature? Okay, see here. There are some properties given, you know, you can see the properties of mercury first of all. Properties of mercury. Students, those who are watching this video, did you understand the experiment, you know, how the water expands on heating? Did you understand? If you have any doubts, please comment in the comment section, students. Okay, let us talk about properties of mercury. What are the properties of mercury? Properties in the sense, how do they behave? Their behavior with the other materials and other changes. Okay, how do they behave? Let us understand. Properties are like that. Properties of mercury, you know, its expansion is uniform. Whose expansion is uniform?
Mercury.
Mercury expansion is uniform. Okay, so that for equal amounts of heat, it expands by equal heights. Okay, next property, let us see that. It's opaque and shining. It's opaque. Opaque in the sense, it cannot pass light through it. Okay, opaque substances and all, you studied in your 6th standard. Opaque substances, the substances which cannot pass light through them and which, you know, give shadow. Opaque substances only give shadow. Okay, so it's not transparent. It's opaque substance and it is shining as well. It is shining substance. Mercury is a shining substance. Okay, right? And it does not stick to the sides of the glass tube. It does not stick. Okay? And recently we have observed some water drops on a leaf. The water drop moving here and there, not sticking to the leaf, right? Same like that, mercury also does not stick to the walls of the glass. What?
Glass.
Right? See here, it does not stick to the sides of the glass tube. Got it? So that we are taking the mercury in the thermometers, right? And it's good conductor of heat. See here, it's good conductor of heat. It's good conductor of heat. Conductor means it's able to absorb the heat and pass the heat through it. Got it?
Yes, I got.
Yes or no?
Yes.
What is conductor? Conductor means absorbs and passes through it, whatever it is. See, mercury absorbs heat and passes through it, and it's very good conductor of heat. Who?
Mercury
is. Next, it's easily available in pure state. It's available. How it is available? In pure state. It's available in pure state. These are the properties that you have to understand in your standard. These are the properties of mercury. Students, did you understand the properties of mercury now? What are the properties? What is the first property? It expands uniformly. And second property is it is opaque and shining. And third property is it does not stick to the walls of the glass tube. And fourth property, it's very good conductor of heat. And fifth property, it's easily available in pure state. Got it? Students, these are the properties of mercury. The question may be asked in your exam, students, what are the properties of mercury which is used in thermometers? Got it? So you please remember the sentences that I taught right now, and you please try to present these words or the sentences in your notebook, students. Okay, got it? Next, let us talk about the properties of alcohol. Properties of what?
Alcohol.
Okay, so these are the students, very good students. They are responding very well. Okay, and now let us discuss about the properties of alcohol. You know what is alcohol? It's also a liquid, same like water, same like other liquids. It's also
liquid.
Okay, in some thermometers, instead of mercury,
alcohol
is taken. Say?
Alcohol is taken.
What is taken instead of mercury?
Alcohol is taken.
Very good. Let us understand what are the properties of alcohol and what are the differences, what are the properties differing from the properties of mercury. Okay. Let us see the properties of mercury right now. Okay.
Mercury, alcohol.
Very good, very good. He is listening, his attention is nice. Okay, very good. Sometimes I say some wrong sentences, you know. Meanwhile, whether you are listening or not listening, I can understand if you correct me. Got it? You have to correct me like that. Okay, don't hesitate or don't keep quiet. Now, what I would like to teach you is properties of alcohol. See, it can record very low temperatures. Very low temperatures can also be recorded by
alcohol.
Right? Next, tell me the property, first property of alcohol.
It can record very low temperatures.
Very good. It can record very low temperatures. Its expansion is also very large to the small changes of the temperatures as well. Okay, small changes of heat, small changes of hotness, also it expands large. Got it? While you are using this alcohol in thermometers, it can be colored brightly. And even in mercury thermometers, the mercury is already, it is shining. But alcohol is not shining, no? So that what we have to do, we have to color it. So these are the properties of alcohol and
mercury
we have completed, and alcohol also we have completed right now. And students, did you understand what are the properties of alcohol and what are the properties differing from the mercury properties? Yeah, once again let me teach you students the properties of alcohol. First property, it can record very low temperatures, and also its expansion per degree Celsius is very large. As you know, it is colorless solution. To identify the level of the expansion, you need to color it, then it will be very easily visible. Got it? So like that, you have to understand what are the differences between the properties of alcohol and mercury as well. Got it? Let us talk about how to use a thermometer. Okay? How to use a thermometer. In the previous class, we have talked about the construction of thermometer. And in this video, let us talk about how to use a thermometer. Okay? How to use a thermometer. And why we should use thermometer? To find the
heat.
What?
Heat.
And temperature. To find the heat and temperature. Okay, now you should make sure that the bulb of the thermometer should be kept close contact with the object which is going to be checked. Okay, now mercury is by default, it is shining material. When you keep the thermometer bulb contact to the body, what will you observe there? You will observe the change of the level of the mercury in the thermometer. Show the image here, you can understand. You know, this is the shine line, that is capillary tube there, no? Okay, that you have to observe. Next, what you have to do is watch the shine line of the mercury in the tube, then the highest point on the scale at which the rays of mercury stops. You have to observe.
Scale.
What you have to observe?
Scale.
The highest point of the scale. Scale means not centimeter scale. The thermometer is already with some markings, no? How the markings are there on the centimeter scale? Same like that. Some markings are there on the thermometer. Got it?
Yes.
So you have to identify that at which level the mercury rising stops. Okay? That point of the scale of the mercury which indicates the temperature, the value of the temperature of that body. Got it?
Yes.
Yes. And for example, there is one example given for you students. And did you understand, students? This is how you have to measure the temperature of any body. Living body you take, non-living body you take. Now, let us say some examples given here. And to find the temperature of your palm, for example, place the bulb of the thermometer in contact with the palm. Okay? For how many minutes? 2 minutes. You have to place what? The bulb of the thermometer in contact with your palm. For how many minutes?
2 minutes.
For how many minutes?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Right. Next. So after some time, you know, you will observe that the level of mercury in the line, you know, in the mercury, in thermometer, the level of mercury will stop rising. That point makes us to understand the temperature of your palm. Example, this is a very simple example to understand how you can measure the temperature of any object. Did you understand, students, what we have discussed in this video?
Yes.
About thermometer.
And what did you understand? Tell me a few points about this virtual video class.
I understand about how mercury is used.
Okay.
Properties of mercury and alcohol.
Okay.
And how thermometer is used.
And what did you understand? And what liquid did you take?
Water.
What are the parts of that apparatus that you did in that experiment?
I will tell you.
Just a moment. Don't interrupt others.
One.
Very good.
One flask.
Flask. How was the flask bottom? Round or flat? Round or flat?
Round.
Round bottom flask, you should say.
And one capillary tube.
One whole rubber stopper. Very good.
Rubber stopper.